И у нас в гостях новичок, одно из самых громких подписаний этого лета, лучший форвард Евролиги Торники Шенгелия. У вас есть уникальная возможность. До конца недели купите футболку с фамилией Шенгелия на спине, игровую реплику, и только распишется на этих майках, у него они уже есть. Вот, отлично. И более того, не просто распишется, а тот, кто купит на этой неделе эти майки, тот сможет заказать себе надпись от Тока Шенгелия, то есть кому-то в подарок, там, не знаю, там, Алексею, там, от Тока, как угодно, что хотите, и это будет на вашей майке. Так что торопитесь, до пятницы можно купить в офисе ЦСКА по адресу Ленинградский проспект 39, строение 3. Потом уже на выходных, до воскресенья включительно, повторюсь, в интернет-магазине. Как ты только принимал решение подписать контракт с ЦСКА? Расскажи, пожалуйста, это подписание было одно из самых громких этим летом.
To be honest, it was an ongoing, ongoing interest from both sides. Many years ago, like a couple of years ago, with me and CSKA, and finally this year we got the chance to make it happen. And I think that I did everything I could with Baskonia team. I think I did the full everything I could. You know, like everything was in my power to do. And I felt like there was a time to change for me to. Leave the Spanish champions and join the EuroLeague champions. It's a very big step, you know. And one of my goals is, one of my dreams is to win the EuroLeague. And I feel like this is one of the best teams right now in Europe. And the players we have, I think we have a pretty good chance to go to the Final Four, and then we'll see what's going to happen from there.
Сколько хинкали ты можешь съесть за один раз?
Not much, to be honest. I have never tried to go for a record, but if I have to eat, I can probably go to up to 20, probably 20, 25. But with 10, I'm okay. With 10, 10 is a limit, to be honest.
Ты пришел в ЦСКА и договорился каким-то образом, пока мы не знаем каким, с Дани Хекетом, уговорил его отдать тебе номер 23, под которым Дэниел Хекет у нас выступал. И Дани сейчас забрал себе другой номер, ты под 23-м. С чем связана именно такая любовь к номеру 23? И как-то связано ли это с твоим отцом, с Кахей Шенгелий, который был хорошим, великолепным баскетболистом?
No, it's not connected to my dad. I like this number. Like, one of the best players wear this number, to be honest. And I don't know, it's something personal for me. I don't want to say right now. When the time comes, I will say this. But yeah, Danny, great guy, man. When I called him and I asked him to consider to let me wear number 23, he didn't even let me finish the sentence, and he said no problem. He said that he respects me as a player and as a person, and he wants me to be comfortable in this team, and if this number is what it takes, that he was willing to give up and give it to me. And that was something amazing, and I was so happy when he told me that. I could not hug him through the phone, but if we were in a person, I would hug him for sure. But yeah, I want to take this opportunity also and say thank you to Danny. And yeah, I'm gonna get him a very nice present pretty soon to him. But this was something special, personal for me, and I'm very happy that such a great guy used to wear this number, and he gave it to me. That's an honor for me also.
Скажи, пожалуйста, какие у тебя отношения с русским языком? Спрашивают, говоришь ли ты по-русски, какие слова ты знаешь на русском языке?
I cannot have a full conversation, but I know спасибо, как дела, ни за что, нормально. This type of stuff, you know, and I think I need like I learned this in school when I was very young, and ever since I haven't used it, you know. So I understand a little bit, but to talk it's very difficult for me.
А против какого игрока ЦСКА тебе было сложнее всего играть? То есть, когда ты играл еще за Баскони?
I mean, there were so many, but I would say three of the most important was Kyle, because we were okay in the same position, and he was guarding me, and I was guarding him sometimes. And of course, Mike James, you know, like also big threat and very important player for CSKA, and Will. Will is tough to guard. He's basically three, but sometimes he plays as a four. And offensively, he had many skills. And I would say those three players was the toughest to guard, and the most important players on our video scouting as well. To be honest.
Ну вот это круто, вот это очень круто. То есть ты фанат Фрэнка Синатра?
Yeah, I love Frank. Frank is one of my favorite singers for sure.
Ты еще играешь на инструменте? Расскажи, на каком музыкальном инструменте ты играешь хорошо?
Yeah, I like to play drums. To be honest, I used to play a lot more a couple years ago, but then I didn't really have that much time. And with three kids, you can't really play a lot of drums. They need to sleep, and it's very noisy. But I can play a little bit of drums, and I generally I like the music, and I would love to learn some other instruments as piano or guitar or something like this, but we'll see.
Спасибо вам, дорогие друзья, за вашу активность. Следите за всеми нашими инстаграмами, фейсбуками и прочим. Так что увидимся совсем скоро в эфире ЦСКА Баскет Шоу. Евгений Седых, Торники Шенгеля. Всем пока.
Чао.